bastard banks. 50 billion quid. How can you lose 50 billion quid and still pay bonuses?
While bank bosses continue to stuff their pockets with money, the ordinary people of Britain are suffering. Fortunately, self-made millionaire Dave Fishwick is going to do something about it.
I want to open a tiny, tiny bank.
He wants to create a better bank, one that can help get his hometown of Burnley up and running again.
There's no money. There's absolutely no money here.
But taking on the big banks isn't going to be easy.
He's going to have to play by a set of rules that actually weren't written for him.
This is the rule book.
This is my idea. I open a tiny little bank in Burnley Centre with very low overheads.
Not really up to much, is it?
No. Give people 5% interest on the savings. We then take that money and lend it out to local people. And this is the big one. Any profit that's left after the overheads are paid, I give it to charity. It can't be that difficult.
That might be straight to jail.
If you go out and raise £50 million, it'll be reasonably easy to set up a bank.
Yes.
You got the money?
No.
Can a minibus dealer from the north of England do a better job than London's top bankers? And could this be the future face of banking?
Hello, I'm Dave from Burnley. The banks are shit. I mean, you go and ask anybody in the street, in anywhere in the country, and say, you know, have you got any love lost for the banks? They're going to say, absolutely not. You know, all they've done is shit on people.
To let, to let, to let. Everything's to let.
There's no money. There's absolutely no money here.
Across Britain, dreams are too often turned into nightmares, simply because of a lack of cash.
The banks aren't lending any money.
Of course, we put all our money into it now, and we contacted our banks to see if they could help us, but in the present circumstances, they can't do.
They just can't get the finance.
And I've put all my art and everything into this, it's just the financial situation of the country, like, not lending.
But local man Dave Fishwick wants to fix things. He still lives just outside Burnley with his wife Nikki, where he fought his way up from builder's labourer to become the biggest minibus supplier in Britain. But when the banking crisis struck, Dave's minibus business was threatened, and his customers could no longer get loans. He survived by lending his own money, and that gave him an idea. If the big banks aren't lending enough money to people who need it, why doesn't he just start his own?
What would you type into Google to say, or to ask it, how to open a bank?
Why, instead of using the word bank, why don't you just say a money lending organisation or something like that?
FSA Compliance Consultancy Services for UK Banking Applications. That might be the one, chicken.
So you just needed to ask, didn't you?
I did. That's what I needed, eh? Now then, who could I ring? Andrew, I've got a really, really exciting project that I'm taking on. I'm trying very, very hard to get in touch with Richard Branson himself. Hello, Simon. My name's David Fishwick. I'd like to speak to Mervyn King, please, at the Bank of England.
What, the number from Mervyn King?
Yes, please. He owns the Bank of England, or he runs the Bank of England. Thread, needle. My pen just went then. Isn't that annoying when it does that? Thread, needle, straight. And that's London. You haven't got the postcode for me sat nav, have you?
I have, yeah. It's EC.
With a few meetings arranged, Dave heads to London to find out how he might set up his bank without taking years to do it.
Richard Branson might be on this. I can have a quick chat to him about the banks.
With around 100 businesses failing every day in Britain, he needs to do it quickly.
What's your name?
John.
Hiya, John. I'm Dave. Marvellous. Looks like we're coming with you today.
I've saved the situation.
Fantastic. Are you sitting with us, John? So Sometimes it's far easier just to go and do something than to try and get permission. It's far easier to apologise after. So sometimes you've just got to set off and do it, and I think that's what we're doing here today.
But banking is tightly regulated by the Financial Services Authority, and only one other brand new high street bank has been licensed in 100 years.
I'm definitely, definitely going to need some help filling this in. Hello there.
Britain's big banks now sell and sometimes miss-sell everything from insurance to investments, and gamble on everything from property to shares. Dave's hoping to go back to basics and bring the same no-nonsense approach he used to build his minibus empire to the world of banking.
This looks like it. Hello, everybody. Is this Zorpa? Hello there. I'm David Fishwick.
Dave is in London looking for ideas and support. The first company he visits, Zopa, matches savers and borrowers through a website.
We do 95% of what banks do, with the exception of taking deposits. So we've managed to avoid the requirement for a banking licence. We do have various other licences, so we have a consumer credit licence from the OFT so that we can lend.
Now that's interesting, the consumer credit licence. Could I use a consumer credit licence to do 99% of what a bank does?
Yes, if you didn't take any deposits from consumers and you simply lent, for example, your own money,
yes,
then you wouldn't need a banking licence. But the moment you start using the public's money to lend, which is after all what banks do, then you need a banking licence.
And is there a way around that in any way, shape or form? Is there a way around not needing the proper FSA banking licence?
I don't think so, if ultimately you're going to be taking deposits.
The reason I'm doing this is I'm trying to make a difference. I'm trying to open a better bank. And I need to find a way around some of the regulations. The regulations are important, they're there for a reason, but the way you've done it, you've found a way around it. Perfectly legally, but you've found a way around it, and I need to go and find exactly the same way.
It's not so much finding a way around things, it's finding a way that what you do is not affected by regulation.
Yes, that's exactly right. In fact, that's so important, I should write that down. Thanks, everybody. See you later. Good luck. Bye-bye now.
The idea is fascinating, and the guy is so enthusiastic. I mean, he's a lovely guy. He's assuming that his force of character and some rationality will overcome rules, because that's the way entrepreneurs think. But because these rules weren't written for people like him, and the people who apply them aren't known for their flexibility, I think he's going to have a bit of an issue if he tries to go the whole hog and become a bank.
As an internet business, Zopa is miles from the old-fashioned high street style bank that Dave wants to set up. He wants to meet and advise his borrowers face to face and prove he can create a better bank.
The fit's atrocious. What size chest are you?
I'm getting the sense that you're a really nice guy.
That's very kind of you to say, sir.
Now, that's just very slightly worrying.
I love your pioneering spirit, Dave. I think it's great. First immediate reaction is you've got no chance.
What you're planning to do there is
almost impossible.
It's too simplistic.
Yes.
Finally, at the end of the day, he reaches London's Mayfair and banking guru, Andrew Hilton.
Hello there. Is it Andrew?
Yeah, it is
indeed. Andrew. I'm David Fishwick. Very pleased to meet you. Yeah, have you any tips or advice about how you think I could go about opening this tiny bank?
Probably go out and raise £50 million. If you go out and raise £50 million, it'll be reasonably easy to set up a bank.
Yes.
You got the money?
No.
Well,
what's the next best thing?
It's going to be difficult. You could start with a credit union, or you could start with a building society. That's possible.
So I could be 99% a bank without the bank licence if I did it the building society way?
Maybe 60% a bank.
Why couldn't I call it a bank? Could I?
Because you're legally not entitled to call something a bank unless it has a banking licence.
How would you go about it if you was me?
It's much harder than it used to be. When I was starting out, if you went to the right school and you had the right kind of parents, then maybe they would, you know, consider that you were a fit and proper person to go into the banking industry. Now they say, look, there are a whole bunch of exams that you've got to take.
Yes.
You've got to prove that you're a fit and proper person. There's no evidence whatsoever that you are.
Yes.
You know nothing about banking. You haven't taken the exams.
Yes.
You can't just go in and say, oh, I want to be a banker. What kind of history do you have as of running a bank?
Well, I've got no history at all, and that's probably one of the problems. You know, I sell minibuses.
You want something that is called a bank and you don't care so much what it does. I'm telling you, you can have a building society and you could do most of what a bank does. I would come to the opening, I'd shake you by the hand, I'd give you a kiss on both cheeks and tell you you've done good.
If I opened a building society?
If you opened a building society. If you open a bank, I would think, oh, here's a guy who's really got ideas above his station.
I'm feeling fairly rubbish, to be honest. No, really, really disheartened by that. I'm not in his clique, that's for sure. You know, I'm not in the private schoolboy's clique, which all the bankers and the investors and all the rest of it probably are. That's not me. Just going to be an awful lot harder than what I thought. A million times harder than what I thought. Why do people say you can't do it? Why don't they say, well, it's going to be tough, but you can do it if you do this, this and this, instead of just saying, you can't do that? It's just, I think people just find it easier to say no. I think the main thing about being an entrepreneur is turning no's into yeses.
London's banking establishment has told Dave Fishwick he has ideas above his station.
I think initially it goes back to your childhood. I mean, as a very young child, I was bullied up until being about 12 or 13. And then I started to fight back. I realised that I wasn't made of glass. And I realised that by fighting back, you won. You beat the bullies. And that's what I've been doing since I was 13 years old.
Well done, pal. Coming in second's nearly as good.
In Britain, unlike other countries, new community banks just aren't allowed. But Dave is going to build one anyway.
Perhaps if we're a couple of hundred yards in that direction or that direction, it wouldn't be the end of the world, because we're still in the location that we really need to be, which is in the heart of Burnley, because that's where the people are and that's where we can do the most good.
A high street bank can spend £1 million just doing up a branch, and their top bosses often pocket millions in bonuses. Dave wants his overheads to be so low that he can offer a market-leading 5% interest on savings.
The concern is really is keeping the costs down and what's the best value for money.
Okay.
It's about having the most efficient bank, because that's where the banks are going wrong. They're spending fortunes they don't need to. And how much is this one?
And here, 9,500.
Is that negotiable? I usually start at half and work my way up. I like it. What's rateable value? £80 a week, £280 in total. Nearly £300 a week, £15,000 a year. Let's go look at a cheaper one.
Okay.
Since the banking recession started, more and more empty properties have become available. So Dave's likely to get a good bargain.
Now this is much smaller, isn't it?
It is. This used to be a flower shop.
Ah. See, now that has a little bit of a bank feel, hasn't it? It's got a little bit of a bank feel. Do you know, I've got a good feeling about that. £6,500, £9,000, £175 a week.
Yep.
It really is small, but small is good because small is cheap, except when it comes to me, because I'm not cheap. Let's have a look in here. It's a little bit like a chicken shed. You'd expect a big bird up top laying egg. It's like one of those old-fashioned wine cellars.
This is a nice feature.
Yeah, it is. It's nice. This could definitely be the bank. Will they take off?
Dave now has premises for his bank for less than £100 a week. Local tradesmen are also getting behind the idea. Many, like builder Mark Pennington, are working for free in the hope of seeing a better banking system.
We have got a sort of decent space up top to put a nice sign. What do you think about in here?
Not really up to much, is it?
No. You can keep chickens.
Yeah.
I need to do enough to it, though, to make people come through door and feel comfortable about parting with money.
Yeah.
Just a quick lick out with pen, carpet on floor, yeah. Counter there, cash machine there, yeah. Bit of a desk, few chairs, safe that's downstairs, it. Chicken shed into something tidier. Yeah. We're done, aren't we?
Yeah. That's it, yeah. And it'll look really well. I think it will.
So you think this could be a tiny bank?
I think this could be the start of a massive bank.
Pretty marvellous.
But believe me, but it's happening all over again.
How are you doing? It's Dave. Hi, everybody.
Dave will be managing the bank, but he'll need someone else to help. Today, he's at local radio station 2BR to give the go-ahead for his recruitment commercial.
Have you seen what happened to markets today?
Yeah, down. Well,
everything's down, isn't it? Mm. I'm going to fix that when I get a chance. But I've just got to open first. That's what everybody does. I brought you a banana, but we only had one fruit bowl.
Are you smart? Are you hard-working? Not frightened of rolling up your sleeves to make things...
Dave's minibus company is one of 2BR's biggest advertisers. Radio producer Bob Kiernan is only too keen to help.
How are you?
Have you made a good job of it?
Well, I'd like to think so.
Nice to see you again.
I'm sure you'll have an opinion.
Yeah. Marvellous.
If you're trustworthy, honest, ethical and computer literate, email writejobforme@hotmail.co.uk with your contact details.
That were brilliant.
Oh, good. Right, OK.
No, usually I have a million things to say.
Yeah, you do. I know. That's well, look, I've done a little bit of an assumptive thing here because I mastered it before you came in.
Fabulous.
All right,
super.
Mate.
Thanks again. All the best, Bob.
Thank
See you next time. There will
good
be
luck.
Another time.
Good luck with everything, mate.
Thanks, Bob.
Bye.
Ta-ra.
Now. Bye.
Look at this. Got a mascot for the bank. Bob, will it for the opening day?
No, go away.
No.
Dave's recruitment drive might be moving ahead, but his passage through the banking regulations is not going well. He's applied for a license to lend money, but his application to take deposits, a banking license, is moving very slowly.
I don't know, I'm tired today. I've been to Manchester in the last 7 days more than I've been for the last 7 years. It seems every bloody person that knows anything about licences or banking or solicitors or accountants or forensic accountants all come from Manchester. And you've got to come in the bloody centre.
Dave's friend and accountant has introduced him to solicitor Keith Arrowsmith. The he thinks Dave will never beat the regulators and should compromise with a small cooperative of members who lend to each other, a credit union.
I think, to be honest, we've got to abandon the idea of opening a bank. That's the bad news. I think the good news is that we could help put together something with a credit union authorisation that might just be possible.
I don't want just a credit union because I haven't set out to open a credit union. I think the credit union is the vessel, or the ship, if you will, that will take me towards my end goal, but it's not what I want.
Dave wants to open a bank to show that they should be a force for good in the community. But the FSA's job is to regulate the banks and protect their customers. Bank licenses are therefore jealously guarded.
We're coming here to open a bank.
We cannot call it a bank. We must. I'm going to have to try and get that out of your system for a while. I don't mind you saying that. That's the guy. That's the goal. That's what we're heading.
That's
for.
That's the goal. I'm happy with that. I want to open a tiny bank. And if I have to go up and round the houses to get to it, then that's fine. But as long as at the end of it, I've got something that is 99.99% a bank, I'm bloody ecstatic.
There are some things you can start working on today. There are some things we can work, say, for the property, you know, where are you going to base this branch?
Well, you've got one. I've got one.
Great.
Can I show you just a quick picture of it, and that'll just give you some idea of the sort of sizes that we're doing. And I have computer-generated the sign that's in there, but...
Okay.
But that's the...
Right.
That's the Bank of Dave.
Okay. Well, what we can be doing in the meantime, although, I said, the word bank doesn't doesn't help me, I'm afraid. But
could it be something like something trading as the Bank of Dave?
The word bank, I think, would be a misdescription.
I mean, I've got this crazy thing in my mind, and people, really intelligent people like yourself, are all saying the same thing. Dave, you cannot have the word bank on your bank. You just cannot have your word bank. And I've got this crazy thing that just saying, Dave, just push forward, just keep going.
I hear what you're saying, but if you pick a word that is a controlled word and you use it without permission, that might be straight to jail.
I feel physically drained. I just feel physically drained. It's a million times harder than I ever thought it was ever going to be. I can't even find my way out now. Try this one. That's the cupboard. It's going to be a bank, and that's that. And it's going to be my bank. The People's Bank. The Burnley Bank. The Bank for Britain. The profitable bank. Not a bastard credit union. In fact, I'm going to put that in big letters underneath it. The Bank of Dave, not a fucking credit union. How many heartaches must I spend before I find the love to let me live again? They should make solicitors in Britain listen to this record before they go to work in the morning, and that take them up that tone. They come into the office singing. Just to make it time, no matter how long it takes, nothing. Fuck off, we credit union. I need a Batman outfit. This is rights for an FSA license.
It's been 2 months since Dave Fishwick set out to open a bank in Burnley.
It's all going wrong. Unless they give me a banking licence, I'm going to jump off. Hello. Are you here for the job? I'm Dave. This is where we're having the interview. I put the ladder there at the side.
Joking, I'm not going up there.
Hiya, I'm Dave. Pleased to meet you, Taz.
It's nice to meet you.
Sorry about that. I just need to drop...
Dave's radio campaign for someone to keep shop has resulted in a handful of candidates. Now, with the help of an employment consultant, he begins the search for his new apprentice.
Well, you've just seen how mad I am to start with, so you can see the sort of bank it's going to be. But you've obviously got... Are you a trained accountant? Or...
I am. I'm training to be an accountant, yeah.
I heard the advert on 2BR.
But it's a really exciting thing to get into, so...
I'm 26 years old.
I'm friendly. I'm very hardworking.
Yes. Excuse me. I'm quite good with computers.
You're all right to get some dinner. This is Mark the Builder. He's drilling and screwing and sewing and stuff in the back.
I'm quite capable of either working as part of a team if it's called for or on my own initiative.
I always want to get the job done right.
Yes.
I'm actually a qualified independent financial advisor.
You did well at school, didn't you? 10 GCSEs.
I did.
A-levels as well. Ring Chris up and tell him you're hired.
No.
Right, back to plastering.
Without any approval to create a bank, Dave gets the premises ready for a grand opening anyway.
I think it's a great idea. We need to make a stand with this lot. They've been ripping us off for ages, haven't they?
Yeah, that's right.
I think you're a brave man for doing it, though.
Non-domestic rate bill. £1,561.64. It's a good start.
With the bank premises nearing completion and bills already coming in, Dave is increasingly frustrated with the FSA's regulations, blocking his plans to take deposits and get the word bank above the door.
I know what I want to call it. I want to call it Bank of Dave. Well, what they're going to let me call it and what I'm going to call it is two different things. And I feel like if I get to end of today and I ain't got a fucking name, I'm just going to ring the FSA and look, I'll say, look, what the fuck can I call this? All the solicitors are saying, Dave, probably better not off you not ringing them because you might upset them. Well, why is everybody frightened? You know, I'm not frightened of anybody on the planet. Why are we frightened of upsetting anybody? You know, the banks have upset millions of people in this country. Why should I be frightened about what the FSA are going to say? Fuck them. You know, I can't do any worse than what the banks have done, because they've lost billions and billions of pounds, you know? And I'm just trying to make a better bank, you know? What are they frightened of? Are they frightened of, do you know what? He might just do it. Do you know what? He might just make a difference in a tiny way, but isn't that going to make them look like a shower of shit? And that's what they're frightened of. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got Chris Delaney in the back, and he's going to sing a little bit of Elvis for us.
New recruit Chris Woods has arrived to a Fishwick-style induction.
One more time.
We can go on together.
Coming out of my skin now, innit? Suspicious man. Dave,
it's a whirlwind introduction to the extraordinary business of trying to open a bank.
And you need to bring yourself to speed as fast as you possibly can. This is Chris.
For Chris, it's also a window into some of Dave's most cherished beliefs and his first principles of business.
Rule number one, never lose money. Rule number two, write this down. Very, very important, this. That's it. Rule number one, never lose money. Rule number two, never forget. Rule number one.
Dave is fitting out his bank at a fraction of the normal price. He's even persuaded a local company to let him borrow their biggest safe. And rather than a million, this refit is costing under £9,000. Even though he doesn't yet have the FSA's permission, Dave is convinced that somehow he will be able to create some sort of bank.
It's going to be a lonely pound for a while, isn't it? When do you film the Benidorm? Is that Thursday?
So convinced, in fact, he set an opening date and asked his celebrity friend Ted Robbins to cut the ribbon.
See you soon. Bye-bye, Ted. Oh, I would love Ted to open it. I'd love Ted to cut the ribbon. Let's hope we can do it. How are you, Ralph? Are we okay to park? Are you sure? Are you having a good day today?
Not bad.
Are you coming to the opening? Oh, we're looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.
2 months ago, Dave Fishwick started his venture to create a tiny bank in Burnley. Despite having no licenses, today is the day he officially opens the door.
We've already got problems. Ted's just rang. He's still in Alicante. They've turned the plane round, and they're saying that there's a minor problem on the plane. He just might make it, but he's got 2.5 hours. Hello there. Chris? What's that? Look when that flight. See if it comes in and see how long it is and how delayed it is. Might just get pissed and not bother opening. Just check.
Right.
Well, I need to know, has the plane set off?
At the moment, it's saying it took off 5 minutes ago. So it should be coming in roughly about 1:45.
So it's actually took off the ground?
It says 12:30 it took off.
So Ted's in the air?
He should be in the air now. Hopefully.
We've no depositors, we've no licence, and we've no Ted. Fucking hell. Do you like cars? What's your name? Connor. You want to sit in it?
Yeah. Oh, go on, I'll take a picture with you.
Go on, then you get yourself sat in there. In fact, why don't you sit in business end? Come round this side and let's sit in the business end, eh?
Oh.
How old are you, Connor?
7.5.
Well, when I was 7.5, I always wanted one of these. And do you want me to tell you something, Connor? If you work really hard in life, and you set yourself a goal, and you think about it, and you work towards it, you're going to get one of these. So everybody that works for me everywhere, just make sure they've all had an invite to come.
Dave has been told that if he calls his venture a bank, he could end up in jail. But he's persisted, and today he's finally going to reveal to the world what it says above the door.
At the end of the day, everybody's giving it 110%. Yeah, Mark!
Do you want to come and have a look at this? Hold on before I cover it up, if that's all right?
Yeah, of course I will.
We'll get this curtain up.
Thanks, Mark.
It's looking absolutely brilliant. That is first class. Absolutely first class.
Hiya.
Free cash. If that don't get them in, no will.
Oh,
she's remembered them. I'm not stressing. I can't even fasten it.
Well, don't fasten it, Elvis.
I need to fasten it to get the thing.
Where's Dave?
I think he's downstairs, he's just getting
himself screwed. I've got a cake here, done a cake, so I'm going to bring it in, that's all.
Let's go. In fact, hang on a minute, let's just shut the safe. I don't want anybody nicking me, quick. I'm not going to stick them in my bloody pocket. I'll tell you what, I'll just add them under them. I'll do it. Deep breath. Here we go. For England. Hello, everybody! Hey, hello! Where else could you be Saturday afternoon? Thank you very much for coming. Guess who's here now? The star guest, all the way from directly from the airport. Who else could it be? The one and only Ted Robbins. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Welcome along.
Macarena.
Hey, Macarena. Absolutely fabulous. Thanks for coming, Ted.
Ladies and gentlemen, I really do mean this. He's a great fella. His heart's right there in it, in the heart of Burnley. And it's great to start it. So we're going to have a countdown for the big opening. This is it. Are you ready?
Yeah.
With some enthusiasm, are you ready?
Yeah.
Five, four, three, two, one. I declare the bank open.
Now officially known as Burnley Savings and Loans, Dave's wannabe bank is well and truly launched, complete with its slogan over the door.
We actually found a way to call it Bank on Dave, Rely on Dave, yeah, with quotation marks and explanation marks.
So it's not Bank of Dave, yes.
Not Bank of Dave, it's Bank on
Bank
Dave.
On Dave, so
Bank
playing,
on Dave.
Dave.
Yeah, that's how we found it.
We should have one in every town.
You're joining with everybody, Scott. We're all friends here. Everybody in Burnley matters. Whatever you want. Hello there.
Are you all right?
Yes. I'm sat here now, contemplating what I've actually done. I've opened a bank. I've got no money in the safe. I've got no license to lend any money out. And the clock's ticking because I've got to find the money for the overheads every week now. We're actually spending money on a daily basis to be open. So unless I get some money in, or unless that license drops on the floor through the letterbox, I'm fucked.
It's 2 weeks since Dave's banking idea was launched.
Right.
2 weeks without being able to take any savings or make a single loan.
Hello, Michael, it's David Fishwick.
But Dave doesn't wait for things to happen. He's an entrepreneur. He makes things happen. Dave thinks the people and businesses of Burnley are suffering, and he feels the big banks are to blame, despite some being bailed out by the taxpayer. He wants his idea of a small community bank to show how it should be done.
Ah, wow! Has he just come now? This very minute? Oh, that's fucking awesome. Okay, look at that.
Dave's venture has got its first important piece of paper.
Oh, we're not messing about now. Tell you what.
It's a consumer credit license.
It's time for a banana, I think, to celebrate. I was saving this for later.
And Dave can now start the business of lending.
Proper. We're on in a bank.
Oh, I could hide beneath the wings of the bluebird as she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring.
Now this actually means that we can lend money to absolutely anybody on the planet.
Now you know how happy I
can be. I gained the bank that we in business.
Good morning, Burnley Savings Alarms.
Without a love one to spend, but how much baby do you really need?
Send it to where it needs to go to get you out the spiral again.
Using his own money and some from wealthy friends, Dave begins his quest to put cash back into Burnley.
People need money fast and they need money now. They need to keep going. And they're the sort of people I'm looking to help. So this is not something I'm going to do in 2 years' time or 3 years' time. We're open. It's 30 Kirby Walk in Burnley. You can come along today and you can borrow money. I want to help the whole area if I can. So we're down at the bank. We're just going to see if the phone's gone mad and we've got 100 people that want to borrow money. And has all the publicity worked? How are you, Chris?
All right.
Has it all worked? Has millions of people's run?
It's kicked off, yeah.
Has it?
Big style, yeah.
Honestly? Never heard of David Fishwick before, but what a breath of fresh air to hear him on the radio. David Fishwick for Chancellor of the Exchequer. Hey, we're not messing about now, are we?
With his new lending ability, Dave can try out his belief that bank managers should meet their borrowers face-to-face to size them up before making a decision. In a village near Burnley, Christine and Keith Turner have been running their cafe for 9 months.
Hello.
Hello.
Hiya.
How are you?
I'm all right, thank you. How are you?
Bloody marvellous.
Lovely.
And tell me, what help you need?
Business is not as hectic and as many people coming over the doorstep as we'd like. Of course, we put all our money into it now, and we contacted our banks to see if they could help us, but in the present circumstances, they can't do.
Keith and Christine had pinned their hopes on a new housing development in the village. It could be the saving of the cafe, if only they could get a loan for new equipment to help cater for the construction workers and the new residents.
Could I just try a little taster, please?
Do you like fish pie?
I'll try a little bit. The thing is, my mum, when I was a kid, used to make me have fish pie on a Saturday dinner time. She wouldn't let me go play out until I'd eaten it all, and I hated it. This is the first time in 30-odd years that I've eaten fish pie. Oh, that's lovely.
Is that all right? I'm actually, why she's got that.
Oh, I knew that'd be good.
Yes, please. Eat a potato pie.
Oh, where do I start? Carrot cake. Quality, freshness. And I'm not a bloody chef. But that's nice.
There's 100 plus houses going to be built in Saturday. We've got to be able to meet that demand.
Yes.
We've only got the 4 ovens.
The Turners need a loan to upgrade their kitchen.
I will not credit search you. You know, I know that you'll pay me back. The way the world of banking's changed is it's become a place to hinder the job rather than to help the job. Really nice to see you.
Taking them on trust and instinct, Dave approves a loan of £8,500. and he'll be back to keep an eye on his investment.
Just feel he's now a friend.
Yeah, and I think when they can see how hard you work, I think he can see into that. He's recognised that, hasn't he? You know? So,
yeah, he wants us to do it, doesn't he?
We're not a bad team, are we?
No, I reckon so.
There we are. Welcome to Aquascope.
Dave's next visit is to Steve Punchard's Tropical Fish Superstore. It's been hit hard by the recession, and he wants a loan to reinvigorate his business.
The last conversation I had with bank manager said, Steve, you've never missed a payment, you've a perfect track record, but they're just not lending money.
Nice to meet you, I'm Dave.
Where's Blossom?
Where's Blossom? What's Blossom? A skunk! I didn't expect that.
How much can we have?
As much as you want.
What do you want the money for?
Sharks. Sharks, because it's
So you want sharks?
Sharks, yeah. Black tip reef sharks that look like proper sharks that grow big.
How will sharks help this business?
Because this business is off the beaten track.
Yeah.
This is what they will travel to for sharks.
I mean, how much does a shark cost?
Probably about £500. And then you've got the build of the new tank. I think you're looking somewhere around about £5,000.
The sharks are a marketing ploy, something Dave is always keen on. But the sharks won't work unless they're publicised. The solution, surprisingly, could be close at hand. Just upstairs, Steve's daughter Leanne runs her own photography studio.
Hi, everybody.
And Steve's son runs a website business.
We keep talking about marketing.
Yeah.
If you'd have seen it in there when it's been busy before, you'll know exactly what a success it can make.
Yeah.
And that's what it needs to do again.
So you know yourself what you need to do.
Sell, yeah.
And it's all at your fingertips.
He's got it here. Yeah, that's it.
You need to get your son involved. You need to get him part of this. This will take you to the next level.
And we also need the money to do it as well.
Of course, yeah. And that's what I'm here to do.
Convinced Steve has everything to turn this business around, Dave decides to lend him the money for his sharks, along with plenty more advice.
So I'm going to give you a few quid. Your lad's going to help you get the internet site built up. Your daughter's going to take the pictures. Everybody's on board.
Yeah.
Well done. And listen to him.
I will
do. Alright.
Alright.
That went well, didn't it? Kicked a bit of arse and I think got him in gear. Tell you what, look at that. That's definitely a bit of me, innit? Da 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 da. Bad to the bone. That's it, innit? This is definitely a bit of me. Fucking clock stopped.
The bank is lending out £25,000 a week. But Dave isn't just relying on his own good sense to decide who he lends to. He's also signed up experienced finance man David Henshaw.
All right then, Dave. Are you doing all right?
Yep. All good news, Dave, or not?
There is a problem at the moment. It's the fact that we are rapidly running out of money.
This is the biggest problem that Dave now has. He needs money from local people to make his bank sustainable. Until he can, he'll have to keep digging into his own pockets to keep the venture alive. But Dave is still pinning his hopes on getting a deposit-taking license from the FSA and has a meeting scheduled with them soon.
Guerrilla marketing. It's the only way that works. Hello. We're opening a little bank here. And we're just hoping for pledges of support.
To support his application, Dave wants to prove to the FSA that the people of Burnley actually want a local bank.
I couldn't ask you to fill one of these forms in for me, could I, please?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can sit in my car if you fill it in. There you go. Just name, address and sign. There's a need for it, and that's the most important thing. There is a need for what we're doing here. We need as many names as I can, so once I get a license, then I'm up and running.
You don't need
oil. No, that's it. Superb. All the very best. Thank you. This can work, given that we get the license. Well, thanks very much for your help. How are you doing, guys? Hello. Give us a wave.
It's less than a week to go before Dave's meeting with the FSA.
It is, yeah.
Where he'll put his case to become a real bank.
Maybe make that a bit smaller. You know, text. Oh, fucking hell. Hello, David. I've spoken to the FSA despite keeping them in the loop about progress with the paperwork. Simon at the FSA tells me today that the meeting was cancelled. I mean, how can they cancel 3 days before I get there?
What she said to me was, she said, we just can't see a way to take this forward in its current form.
Right.
You would need a technical minimum of, they say, €5 million. They were then saying several million over and above that.
The FSA want Dave to prove he could set aside a large sum to ensure the solvency of the bank before they meet.
€10 million. So they want, now they want €10 million. That's absolutely ridiculous.
I can't disagree with you. It's mad.
They're scared of me actually doing this. These people, they'll try and get you down and you have to let them, you know. I'm hard as nails and I shall not let them get me down, you know. One way or another, we're going to make this happen.
Okay.
All right, Chris. Thanks for ringing. See you soon. Ta-da. Bye. Bye. €10 million. That's what he just said to me. It's political. One way or another, it's going to happen. Well, it's fucking here. It's already on. I don't know. I'm not shutting. There's no chance I'm fucking shutting. Bollocks to him.
Next time, Dave gambles in stocks.
Up and down.
And commodities.
Take that wall down.
Gets a rush on the bank.
A tear of coffee, Sam. I'm afraid you might have to take the lid off, just have a look which one it is.
And tries to take his banking model nationwide.
Let me tell you, I'd go to the end of the earth for you. Okay. We're a banker, I wouldn't go to the end of the pavement.
That's your opinion. I'm not going to come in.